Hello guys, welcome in this new video. In this video I want to talk about how much is crucial to choose the correct layer for deploy our decentralized application. So stay with me for a couple of minutes because we want to explore the pros and cons of the Ethereum mainnet and discover new technology which is represented by zkEVM proposed by Polygon. So, when we think about Ethereum, we think for sure the best and most important blockchain layer in all the blockchain space because of its community, its comproved reliability, and its history and its brand. The problem is that for all this aspect is a really congested network and gas price to send our transaction are really high. So, especially for small transaction, we should think another alternative to deploy our decentralized applications. This is because of the trilemma. The trilemma says empirically that it's impossible to reach the top of the performance considering security, scalability, and decentralization. But in this case, a blockchain developer has to trade off with the three aspects, reaching the best compromise. Now let's see what did Polygon with zkEVM. Before I go deeper into the zkEVM, I want to tell that the compatibility with Ethereum is almost complete with zkEVM. This is because all the tool that we use to develop on top of the mainnet of Ethereum works in zkEVM. And there is the possibility with a bridge to transfer all the asset from the mainnet till the zkEVM and vice versa. Here you can see an high-level design of zkEVM node. The most important component to look at are the sequencer and the aggregator. Now let's see how the flow to synchronize the layer 2 with the layer 1 works. From this high-level flow is simpler to understand how zkEVM works. It works mainly in two steps. In the first steps, the sequencer merge all the transaction of the users and send to an Ethereum smart contract. And from here we can already understand how we create more efficiency because it's not that each single user send its own transaction, but all the transaction are merged together. And these transaction are organized in batch. In the second step, there is the aggregator. The aggregator catch these transactions and then create a proof with a zero knowledge algorithm to validate and consolidate them. So when these steps are passed, the transactions are considered valid. So what I understood studying zkEVM is that maybe we don't need to create a competitor of the Ethereum, but we just need to bring more efficiency in the Ethereum ecosystem. So a blockchain developer has the ability to choose where is more convenient to deploy an application on a layer 2 or maybe directly on the layer 1. And please tell me what do you think about this video. Many thanks. Bye from Valerio.